So this is example 65. Hello future engineers, if you like what I'm doing, please don't forget to share my videos to your friends and to your friends' friends. And also don't forget to subscribe to my channel if you like what I am doing. A simple beam 12 meters long has section C 4 meters from the left support. Compute the maximum values of the functions due to three equal concentrated loads of 15 kilonewtons each and spaced 3 meters apart. So the discussion of this is in the preceding lecture video, and this is just the example or application. So if you want to understand more, although I present the solution in such a manner that you can easily follow using statics. And the second way is using influence lines, but I limit the use of influence lines here. I just use statics. So in this case, A is 4, distance of point C from the left support. Then H is 3 meters, distance between the three equal loads. And P is 15 kilonewtons, while L is 12 meters long. So for maximum reaction at A, the arrangement would be the leftmost load should be over the support, as shown. Then we'll just compute for RA. This corresponds to RA max. So since the loads are equally spaced and they are equal, the resultant is 3 times 15 or 45 kilonewtons, and the distance of that 45 kilonewtons from B is 12 minus 3, so 9. So our summation moment at B equals 0, about B equals 0, RA times, or RA max times 12 equals 45 times 9. So again, RA max times 12 equals 45 times 9. So RA max is equal to 33.75, although there is a formula which I derived. The formula was 3P times L minus H all over L. And I will not use that formula, although I derived that and I can remember that. I'll assume that I cannot remember that, as long as I know how to place the load, because that's the important thing, and apply statics. Next, for maximum shear at C, this is the influence line for shear at C. A is 4, B is 8. So this is negative A over L, negative 4 over 12, so negative 1/3. And this is B over L, 8 over 12, so positive 2/3. Therefore, the maximum shear at C is such that the leftmost load is over 2/3, then the other two over this longer segment, using the influence lines. So this should be the arrangement. But maximum shear at C is simply reaction at A for this arrangement. So since A is 4, therefore 4 plus 3 plus 3 is 10. The span is 12, so this remaining distance is 2. So that we can solve RA easily. So that's 2. Summation moment B equals 0, RA times 12 equals, again, 45 here, times 5. 3 plus 2 is 5. Then shear, maximum shear at C at the point is RA, just RA, considering the section just to the left of C. So I do not show M sub C anymore, just V sub C, and it is equal to RA. So V sub C max equals RA, and to solve for RA, we sum up moments about B for this arrangement. So RA times 12 equals 45 times 5. So RA is 18.75 kilonewtons, so V sub C max is also 18.75 kilonewtons. Then for moment at C, because A is 4 and 4 is 12 over 3, it satisfies the criterion that either case controls, or case 1 or case 2 controls. Case 1 is when the center load is over point C, and case 2 is when the leftmost load is over C. So for case 1, the center load is over C, so that means, because A is 4, that means this is 1 meter, so the maximum moment at C is simply RA for this arrangement times 4 minus 15 times 3. So that is by statics. If you want to derive the ordinates under the leftmost load, then derive it, because AB over L is 4 times 8, B is 8, A is 4, divided by L 12, so it is 8/3. So from there, by similar triangles, you can derive the ordinates to the influence line. So again, RA times 12, summation moment about B, equals 45 times 8. So R sub A is 30 kilonewtons. So the formula is, for RA is 3P times B divided by L. And the moment here is RA 3P over L times A minus P times H. But although I mentioned the formula, I will not use that. I assume that I cannot remember that, as long as I know how to arrange the loads and apply statics. So the other way is you derive the ordinates to the influence lines. I leave that to you. So MC max is RA, which is 30 times 4. We sum up, we take moment about this point C here, then minus 15 times 3. So MC max is equal to 75 kilonewton meter. For the second situation, the leftmost load is over C, because that's either case controls. So if the center load is over C, then it is just this arrangement here, and it is just MC max is just RA times 4, or RA times A. Since we already computed R sub A for this loading position, and it was 18.75, so MC max is 18.75 times 4, which gives the same value of 75 kilonewton meter. And finally, we have absolute maximum shear. The absolute maximum shear is either the reaction at the left or the right support, and it is equal to RA max, just like here. So it is equal to 33.75 for absolute maximum shear, 33.75 kilonewtons. Then for absolute maximum moment, that happens at the center of the beam when the center load is also over the center, as shown in the figure. So there's a formula which I derived. It was 3P L over 4 minus pH, but I will not use that. I'll just compute for the reaction. You can derive, again, you can derive MC max by deriving the ordinates here and the ordinates here. I will leave that to you and show that MC max is equal to 75 kilonewton meter. Then here also, but I'll use statics. The reaction here is 15 plus 15 plus 15 over 2, so 45 over 2. This is 3 meters because this is the center. This is also 3 meters, so that the length of the beam totals 12 meters. So RA is equal to 45 over 2 kilonewtons. Then the absolute maximum moment occurs at the center. We cut the center and consider forces to the left of that section. So maximum moment at sea, absolute maximum moment at sea is 45 over 2 times 6 minus 15 times 3. So M absolute max equals 45 over 2 times 6 minus 15 times 3. So M absolute max is equal to 90 kilonewton meter. So that's it. And the other solution is you draw the influence lines for moment at the midspan, which is L over 4, 12 over 4, which is 3, then derive the ordinates here would be 1.5, 1.5. So another way is 15 times 3, 45, plus 15 times 1.5, plus 15 times 1.5. Why 1.5? Because the ordinate at the center is 3, and 15 is equally distant from B, as well as this 15 here equally distant from A. So therefore, half of 3 would be the ordinate, 1.5. So 15 times 3 for the center load, 45, plus 15 times 1.5, plus 15 times 1.5, that gives you 90 kilonewton meter. So that's the other way. I just explained it, but the answer is the same.